तो इंशाल्लाह वी गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अल्लाह ने शैतान ने बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम सो वी डू आयत नंबर 74 ऑफ सूरह अल बकरा दिस आयत इज आफ्टर द स्टोरी ऑफ बनी इसराइल वेयर अल्लाह सुभान व तआला आस्क्ड देम टू सैक्रिफाइस अ काउ एंड दे वर रिलक्टेंट टू डू दैट सो दिस आयत इज स्टिल अबाउट बनी इसराइल बट हियर अल्लाह सुभान व तआला सेज That what happened to them as a result of their continuous disobedience to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. So we'll do a simple translation first. Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala says, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim." ثم قصت قلوبكم. Then your hearts became hard. من بعد ذلك after that. فهي كالحجارة. As if they are like stones, they became so hard that they are like stones. Aw ashaddu qaswa, or even harder than stones. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Taala mentions that what are different things that happen to the stones, which make them softer than the hearts. So the first part is that. وَإِنَّا مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that among the stones, there are some stones. لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ From them comes out gushing. مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارِ The water, the stream of waters come out gushing. So stones split and the water flows through them. Okay. Then another example of the stones is that وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا And among them, among these stones, lama are some stones, some. يَشَّقَّقُ Which is split, which break down into pieces. فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَا And the water comes flowing through them. And we see that in the oceans and different places in the mountains, that water can split the stones and they separate. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says a very unique thing in the third part of that. وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا And indeed among these stones, lama are those. يَحْبِتُ means to fall down. So they fall down, the stones fall down. مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ By the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you see, notice that some stones which are sitting on the top of the mountains and they start rolling down for whatever reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this is because even the stones have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the khashiyah okay and so even the stones can go through these stages but the hearts of the people when they become hard then nothing works on Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ And Allah is not unaware. أَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ Whatever you do. He is fully aware of what people are doing. Okay? So in specific, this is the ayat about Bani Israel. But it can apply to anyone who disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the guidance has no effect on that person. Okay? So with that, we will do, inshallah, translation, the breakdown of the words. The word ثُمَّ Thumma means then. But thumma usually comes after something happens and then after something has to happen. Later on, after that. So this is a very common word. Thumma means after or then. Thumma means then. The next word starts with these three letters Qaf, Seen, and Waw. Qaf, Seen, and Waw. And the meaning of these three letters is to become hard. Okay? To become hard. Something becomes hard. Become hard. Qaf, Seen, and Waw means to become hard. Okay? Now, if we look at the grammar of these three letters, fa, an, and nam, which means to do, fa'ala, and if we put a ta at the end, it becomes fa'alat. The meaning of this grammar is she did. Which means third person feminine gender and the past tense. When you put it, you take three letters and you put a ta at the end and pronounce fa'alat, it brings the grammar of feminine gender, third person and in the past tense. So if we apply that rule here, this word will become af with a fata, waw, kaf with a fata, sin with a fata, waw with a fata, and ta with a sukoon. Qasawat. Okay? So the meaning of this will be, she became hard. If we just took the literal meaning, she became hard. Okay? And what also happens is that this waw is a weak letter and there is a fata on that. So in the pronunciation, this waw drops out, it is not pronounced. So the word is left qasat. Qasat. And that's what the word is in the Quran. Qasat. Okay. Literal meaning is that she or it became hard. And we will see that what is the meaning of this when it combines with the next word. Okay? So the next word starts with these three letters, Qaf, Lam, and Ba. And this means to turn. Qaf, Lam, and Ba means to turn something. And the word that we know, Qalbun. Qalbun means heart. Qalbun, this we call qalb. Qalbun means heart. Why do we call it? Because heart keeps turning back and forth. So that's the reason. Qalbun is called as a heart. Okay? Its plural is qulubun. Qulubun is the plural. It means hearts. Qalbun is singular. Qulubun is plural, hearts. Okay. Now, kum means you, is a plural. Okay. Kum is a pronoun, you, plural. Okay. So when you combine these two words, qulubun and kum, by the rule of combination of mudaf mudafila, this is pronounced as qulubukum. Qulubukum, one dhamma is not pronounced when you combine this noun and a pronoun together. So the word is qulubukum, which means your hearts. Okay? So the qulubukum means your hearts. Now, in the Arabic grammar, whenever there is a group, and you're talking about the group, then the grammar of first the feminine gender is used for that. So, the meaning will be, then you don't have to say the word she, and it will become, your hearts became hard. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ Your hearts became hard. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Bani Israel that after that, after your disobedience, your hearts became very hard. Became hard. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ Okay. After that are the words Mim Ba'adi Zalik. Okay. So actual word word is ba'adun and zalika. Zalika means that, and ba'adun means after. Zalika means that, ba'adun is the original word in Arabic, means after. Okay? Now, if I combine these two together, it will be again, as the rule is that you pronounce one Dhamma. So it will be Ba'adu Zalika. Okay? So this will become Ba'adu Zalika. After that. Okay? Now when we put Min before that, Min means of or from. And also, min is a harfijar. Harfijar looks at the second, the word after that. And on the last letter, it changes dhamma to a kasra. So this dhamma will become kasra. Okay. Also, in the tajweed, when there is a ba after the noon, yeah, then you pronounce min. So you pronounce mim ba'ade zalika. Okay? In English, you don't have to say of or from. You can say after that. Of after that or from after that. But English, the correct English will be after that. Okay? So this whole word will be after that. After that means after you have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much, the Bani Israel, Allah says that your hearts became hard. Means nothing is going to affect them. So from this point, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the example how much hard they became. So, fa and hiya are the two words. Fa means so. And hiya, actual meaning is har or it. Okay? Now, as I said that, qulubukum is the plural, and for the qulubukum, the grammar of a feminine person is used, one like qasat. So this hiya, she is actually pointing to the hearts. So because in English we have to translate correctly, so we will translate hiya as they, and they are actually hearts. They, then they. Okay. For here, so they. Or they, or here actually means here hearts. Okay. So they. They means hearts here. Okay. Then the word is kal hijarati. So let's look at this word. So the word starts with these ha, jim, and ra. These are the three root letters. And the noun is this hajarun. Hajarun means stone. Hajarun means stone, like hajra aswad. It's the same word, stone, black stone. So, hajarun is actually the right word, means a stone. Okay? Its plural is hijaratun. Hijaratun means stones.
Okay. Is the word hijrat also derived from?
No, hijrat means migration. And that starts with a different ha, small ha. This is capital. Hijrat starts with this ha. This small ha. And this means migration. But the capital ha, big ha, is this one. Hijaratun. Now, if I put al before that, al means the stones. And when you put al, then these two dhammas are pronounced as one. So the word will be now al hijaratu, the stones. Al hijaratu, the stones. Okay? And we are going to put one more word before that. Ka. Ka means like or same. Same or as. Or like. Okay? And ka is also a harf jar. So what it does, it changes this dhamma to a kasra. So now, if you pronounce this word, you combine kaf with lam, kal hijarati. That's the word in the Quran. Kal hijarati means like the stones, same as the stones. Okay. Same as stones. Or like stones. So now if you try to translate up to this point, the meaning will be, then your hearts became hard. After that, so they were like stones. They were like stones. They became so hard that they were like stones. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says one more thing. Okay? Let's look at that. Aw ashaddu qaswa. Look at these words. Aw in Arabic, alif waw, aw means or in English. Then the next word starts with sheen, dal and dal. This means to be strong. Shadid or shiddat, these are the words. Something which is strong. Okay. So the word ashaddu is the superlative beginning. Ashaddu means stronger. Okay. It's a superlative. Shadid means strong. Ashaddu means even strong or more severe. Okay. Like Hasan means good, Ahsan means better. So when you put an alif, it becomes the superlative beginning in English. So when you put an alif, it becomes superlative.
ये जो शब्द है, तो ये तजवीद में शब्द इसी से आया है, तजवीद में
वो शब्द
वो इसी से आया
है। यदि यू प्रोनाउंस ट्वाइस स्ट्रॉन्गर लेटर, यू प्रोनाउंस ए लेटर stronger, which means you pronounce twice. So the roots are from the same. We call tashdeed or shadda. The roots are same. So and we represent that by this little thing there. It's the same root. So ashaddo means stronger. Shadid means strong. Ashaddo means stronger. Okay. Then the other word we just saw, seen. Wow, which means to become hard, and the noun of this is aswatun. Aswatun means hardness. Hardness, the quality of something which is very hard.
Aswa is hard.
Hardness. Sakhti. So the meaning will be aw ashaddu qaswa, and is stronger in hardness. Is stronger in hardness than the rocks, the stones. So hearts became harder than the rocks or the stones. That's the meaning here. First Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they became like stones, and then he further says that actually they became stronger than stones in hardness. Okay. Severe, even more hard. How stronger in hardness.
Maybe just harder?
Harder, yes. The right will be to combine both of them and translate even harder. So you can translate both of them together, even harder. Okay. Separately, stronger in hardness, even harder. Aw ashaddu qaswa. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about some qualities of these stones. Okay, so let's look at the first of them. Wa inna min al hijarati. Let's look at these words. Wa means and, and the word inna means surely, indeed. And we just saw this word, al-hijaratu, means the stones, and min is a harf jar, so it will become min al-hijaratu, of the stones. Min means of or from or among, okay? And the next word was al-hijarati. Hijaratu actually al hijaratu, so this will become min al hijarati, because min will change this to a kasra here. Min al hijarati, among the stones. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and indeed, among these stones. So, Vainna Minal Hijarati is and surely among the stones. And surely among the stones. And then the word is after that is la ma. It is made of two parts, la ma.
Yes. Does the mineral, the presence of mineral has changed the...
Yes, so it was al-hijaratu, min is a harf jar. It has the same effect as ka had in the beginning. So al-hijaratu became al-hijarati. Okay. So la and ma. La is called harf taqeed. It emphasizes. And again you can say the meaning of this la is surely. And ma means that which. So among the stones are surely some or that which. Some stones are. Okay. So lama means surely that which. Or those. Surely those. So among these stones are some stone, and we're going to see what are those stones. The word is yatafajjaru minhul anhar. Okay? So that word starts with fa, jim, and ra. Fajara. Okay? And this belongs to three letters, which is Babe Fa'ala. And we create